There are a few things you'll need to do to prepare your label artwork for uploading before placing a custom order with Consolidated Label. Following these steps will ensure the smoothest ordering process for your labels and the best looking, cleanest results once printed. We'll take you through creating the file with the correct presets, creating the die line, centering your artwork in the die line, final design considerations, and exporting. To start, open Adobe Illustrator. Create a new file, then select the Print tab. You may need to change some of the presets here. For the units of measure, make sure inches is selected. You don't want to use bleed presets. It's better to include your bleed within the artboard. Just enter the height and width of your final label size in inches, adding 1/8 of an inch to both the width and height to allow for 1/16 inch bleed beyond the label size. For example, if your label is 4 by 6 inches, you should enter 4.125 by 6.125 inches. Next, expand the Advanced Options menu. For color mode, select CMYK Color, and under Raster Effects, select High 300 PPI. These presets will ensure your design's color and image quality when printed. Once you've adjusted these presets, click Create. To create the die line or the cut line of your label, we'll start by making the outline. For rectangular and square labels, use the Rectangle tool. For circular labels, select the Ellipse tool by right-clicking the Rectangle tool. Click anywhere on the canvas and enter the dimensions of your final label size. Next, align the shape to the center of the canvas. You can do this by clicking on Window, Align, then with the object selected, choose both Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center. Next, go to Window, Attributes, and check the Overprint Stroke box. Remove the fill of the shape by double-clicking on the fill box and selecting the transparent swatch. You should be left with just the outline of your shape. This is your die line. Make it stand out by changing its color. Double-click on the stroke box and select CMYK, red, or cyan, whichever is more noticeable against your artwork. If your label has rounded corners, adjust the corner radius of your shape in the Properties panel. 1/8 of an inch is a common corner radius. Make sure your label artwork is centered and goes up to the edges of the canvas, past your die line, to avoid unwanted blank spaces on your printed labels. Grouping all of your artwork together will make it easy to move around. To do this, select all of the layers of your artwork and use the shortcut Ctrl-G or Command-G on Macs. At this time, make any necessary final changes if your artwork includes text or linked files. Converting your font to outlines will ensure your font will look the same when printed. Use the shortcut Ctrl-A or Command-A for Macs to select all. Then in the top menu, select Type, then Create Outlines. Any image on the canvas with an X going through it is a linked file. Embed these in your artwork by going to Window, Links, then selecting Embed Images in the Links panel. Now you're ready to export the file. Go to File, Save As, keep the file as an Adobe Illustrator file, and select the location where you want to save your file. For version, select Illustrator CC Legacy. After this, your artwork is ready to be submitted to us for review. If you need more assistance in getting your artwork ready, reach out to us at 1-800-475-2235 or visit consolidatedlabel.com today to get started on your custom label order.